Hey guys, Dan the Wolfman here, the combatsystem.com, catch-jitsu.com. Welcome to MMA versus Systema real sparring video. The first half is real MMA sparring, including against pro fighters and a champion MMA fighter in Japan, as well as a lot of bare knuckle sparring type training. I hope you guys will enjoy it. There I am intercepting his intention with crossface biomechanics against that pro pancrase fighter there. Another punch, crossface, defending takedown defense there. Isn't that interesting? Guys, I've been doing martial arts like 34 years. And, I've been exposed to Systema for about 20 of those last years. Oh, look at that inside knife defense to the throat chop. Wasn't that at the end subway fight in John Wick 2? And kneeling down on the knees against a shorter Asian fighter, didn't we see that? Almost shot for shot exactly at the end of John Wick 3, as I filmed there with a shorter Malaysian guy in 2014. Here I am doing the flying squirrel defense people said would never ever work from Systema against a standing guillotine choke by a bigger heavyweight, MMA champion, heavyweight fighter, purple belt in jiu-jitsu. Knows how to do guillotine chokes. Yes, I did. So you can too. Be open-minded, my friends. Try and learn a little bit. So try and look at the concepts of looseness, non-telegraphic strikes, hitting outside the peripheral vision, sensing intention, stealing intention, structure of your spine, strength, breathing, breaking structure of your opponent. You'll see that in other videos I have, like the real instinctive Russian self-defense video, the learn hard hit video, the FSB Systema breaking structure, KGB takedowns video. Look up those video guys and you'll get a more idea of how you could actually apply things in self-defense and combatives when things are for real. Here I am at Maha Sakurai's dojo in Tokyo, Japan. And just watch the video and stay tuned, guys. And I think you'll like the bare knuckle stuff as well. So guys, I got exposed to Systema in 98 or 99 in a back alley after JKD training from George Pogacich. Look him up on YouTube and subscribe to his channels. He is amazing. He's the last guy I'd want to fight in a dark alley or to the death. If you haven't felt someone amazing and you're only judging from YouTube, especially if you don't have experience like I do, you know nothing, Jon Snow. You know nothing. People on the internet bad-mouthing know nothing. They haven't felt someone with true power and true precision. They haven't ever felt a true master in their entire life in martial arts. So, Systema is like a masterclass or PhD program to someone that already has their bachelor's. And you're talking to people that haven't even graduated high school. Not everyone in Systema can fight. A lot of the videos look silly, even from the great guys, and certainly a lot of the videos from a lot of people look bad from the bad guys. They're not very good. And if you haven't trained in it, if you haven't experienced it, if you can't learn from videos, visual learner like I am, you probably can't tell the difference. I know it's difficult. I have never said otherwise. I have never claimed it's the best style for everyone, especially beginners. But be open-minded, take what is useful, and hopefully you can learn some things from this video. Here I am going against the former pancrase champion Suzuki. Look at me hitting from the outside of the peripheral vision. Look at me hitting on the inside, multiple hits with one arm, things of that nature. So guys, I hope you enjoy this video, and I just don't. Why are you going to listen to them? Why are you going to listen to anonymous people? Did they fight pro? No. Did they train with the top pros around the world for 20 plus years like I did? The top pro fighters? The best instructors? No. Did they actually spar for off and on for over 20 years? No. Have they been in multiple opponent fights multiple times? No. Have they defended themselves against weapons before? No. So their opinions shouldn't matter. Especially if they just saw some videos and, like, yes, a lot of it looks silly. You can't understand the things that a high-level person can do unless you've gone with a very high-level person. And, yes, not everyone out there even teaching is high-level. George is extremely high level. Out of all the people in the world, that includes all the light heavyweight UFC fighters, all the heavyweight fighters I've gone with, George S. Pogacich has got multiple YouTube channels. Looking up. He's in Michigan. You want that? You want Systema? Go to him. Set up private lessons. He's the last guy I would want to fight in a dark alley. He's the last guy I would want to fight to the death. People badmouth because a lot of it's showing slow, whatever. But people cannot even replicate the instinctiveness with the precision and the biomechanics that the top people have. Like, not even. All the badmouthers, okay, duplicate that. See if you could duplicate that. He didn't do it choreographed. We'll let you do it choreographed. Let's see if you can duplicate the precision choreographed. They couldn't do it. Just think about the precision. Okay? Now think about that they can hit loose, hit deep, hit hard, hit non-telegraphic. Haven't we seen cookie-cutter MMA fighters only focus on physical attributes? Strength, steroids, speed, endurance, EPO. That's not going to be lasting you when you're 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 years old. That's not going to last you when you have horrible diseases like I do. But even though I wasn't the most athletic guy, even though I was very short compared to a lot of the guys I really like sparred heavy MMA sparring with over the years. The Rampages, Tito's, Tanks of the world, the Tim Sylvia's, you know, the 6'8", 300 pounds when he was heavyweight champion, Verdum a few times, Kane once, Herschel Walker once. I've gone against a lot of good guys and a lot of big guys. Do pretty good. And even when I do get hit, I roll with it. I also go more often than they go a lot of times. How do I do that? Distance control and sensing intention, stealing intention, higher level concepts that not all of you are going to get, but I hope this video helps explain some of it to you. Here I am at Korean Zombies Gym in Seoul, Korea, and I'm playing with some cage of dope. Very interesting. Didn't we see a bit more cage of dope from Anderson Silva after this fight, after this video came out, the video where I'm in Korea doing this here? Looseness. Non-telegraphic. Unusual angles. Conor McGregor, loose and flowy. Now, he'd be too static in his punches, too much muscular tension in a way, and that would tire him out. But his movement would be loose and flowy, right? And Anderson Silva's, people that excel. You're going to see loose movement, and you're going to see less telegraphing. From the old days, all this strong power hooks with the telegraphing shoulders and all of that. Guys, Systema's like a master class for the experienced martial artist. It's like a PhD program for someone that already has their bachelor's. Will most beginners get a lot out of it? No. Are there a lot of videos out there from people that have horrible balance and just are not very good martial artists? Yes. Does a lot of what I do look different? Yes. But except for the haters and people hate what they don't know. What they can't understand, what's different. Even in my grappling. So what if I didn't look cookie-cutter Muay Thai, cookie-cutter boxing MMA fighter? So what if I didn't look cookie-cutter Jiu-Jitsu on the ground? It's funny all the pros that I got with all these weird submissions. Systema and catch wrestling is like a biomechanics masterclass for your martial arts, understanding human anatomy and physiology, how the body works, how to twist and break things instinctively in the moment. I hope you're enjoying this, and even if you're not, the bare knuckle stuff to me is even a little more interesting. So in a minute here, we'll kick over to the bare knuckle stuff and how it can teach you line familiarization to pick up things from strange angles, throw from strange angles, throw from outside the peripheral vision, intercept up the straight the center. There you see me going with my Kazakh student, Steve. And a lot of what I do, guys, yes, it's hybrid. It's systemic concepts. It's mixed with 52. It's mixed with cross-arm defense. It's mixed with a lot of things. It's hard not to. But systema just means system. And if some systema guys say, well, I got a little too much pressure in my body or whatever, I'd like to see them spar. I'd like to see them spar. They can't even go at this level, which some of you think is too light. But when I do this bare-knuckle stuff, guys, basically it's bare-knuckle street boxing, if you will. Usually if the guy's got a cup on, I will put knees to the body and groin kicks in. I think that's important as well for self-defense, learning how to kick up underneath where the guy can't see it. And yes, there is a difference. There is ways of hiding strikes, even straight punches going from underneath the upward angle, outside in, like long hooks, like Fade War, knocked a lot of dudes out with. He also had the nastiest ground to pound in Pride. Didn't Fade War whip outside the peripheral vision like I teach in my videos, how to do Russian long hooks like Fade War, Milianenko? The video, guys, you might want to watch. Guys, if you like Systema, if you're interested more, there's even more to it about that really applies to self-defense from angles from the side, from rolling off sucker punches with your shoulders, as you see me do here. Sometimes I get too sideways. That's on purpose. That's the practice against sucker punches or a crowd, a self-defense, right, as you might in a club or a riot. Look at my real instinctive Russian self-defense. So type in Catch-Jitsu, real instinctive Russian self-defense. Catch-Jitsu, learn hit hard. Learn hit hard. You will want to watch that video to get more appreciation. And Catch-Jitsu, type in Catch-Jitsu, FSB, Systema Breaking Structure, KGB Takedowns. That should get you, and that's especially interesting to maybe older judoka and aikido people. You'll see a lot of kazushi there and about the body and the spine. Some of it's hard to explain if you haven't trained your whole life. This is just language to me, since that's what I've done my entire life. So I hope you guys like this video. I hope you will give it a thumbs up, at least, to trying to put out what I have that's actually soft bare-knuckle sparring, medium bare-knuckle sparring, medium sparring against pro fighters and champion pro fighters. Really doing it instead of just talking about it, instead of just bad-mouthing it, trying things out. Now trying to explain things to you. So yes, a lot is, you do see I mix in a lot of deflections and forearm blocks and things of that nature. Some of it kind of looks like what the Diaz brothers even train. A little slap boxing bare knuckle, doesn't it? Some of it looks like some stuff Yoel Romero has messed people up. Some of it looks like stuff Anderson Silva has done at times, doesn't it? Martial arts is martial arts. Stop being so worried about that style sucks. This, worry about you and how good you can get and take what is useful. If I repeated myself a lot in this video, guys, it's because I already recorded the audio once and it didn't capture properly. So I'm sorry about that. I have been to a seminar, Vasiliev seminar, a couple days, and there was like 100 people there. Yes, 90 people there were delusional. They couldn't fight their way out of a paper bag. But there are 10 people there, including older, which is important, and some probably had backgrounds in martial arts, just like George did, just like Vladimir himself did. Those people had something real. I think they could adequately defend themselves. There are being instinctual and loose when you're surprised is a very good thing. I was working at a gun store, and suddenly I was talking to one customer, and suddenly I just noticed to my right, a gun was pointed right at me. All of a sudden, someone had just walked up and pulled out a gun and pointed right at me. it wasn't a Krav Maga thing. I instinctively snatched it, got off the center, and just ripped it. Just an instinctual quick snatch. Like you see a lot of the stuff I do in those videos. I just snatched it right out of their hands. This is for one of your jumps in transitional spaces, the way real attacks happen, guys. From the sides, behind a car, hiding behind a bush, the corner of a wall, just standing on the corner, and then they jump you. I'm not saying you shouldn't learn MMA and kickboxing, maybe Kyokushin, maybe judo, wrestling and boxing. You should do all that stuff when you're younger. But when you're ill, sick, injured, and older, don't you want to be able to defend yourself too? Again, not saying all Systema people, even instructors, are good. A lot of the videos look bad. I can kind of tell watching the videos what is really high level and what is no good at all. And I know to people that have not really trained in it, it's hard to see that. I get that. And a lot of what I do is not strict Systema. It's more putting Systema concepts in with everything else I do, which I think is what a lot of people are maybe more interested in, or maybe interested in after watching this video. So, this guy here was the first time I met up with him, and Jonathan here, he had studied Systema a year while in Israel living in a kibbutz. So he wasn't training Krav Maga or K-pop. He had a bit of a Kyokushin background and then trained Systema a year. And he's also fought full contact a few times in like Daido Juko, Kudo type fights. This was our first time meeting up, and we did soft stuff and I explained and kind of taught. And now we're just kind of playing around, you know, latest type sparring. So here I'm sideways, guys. Like, you might stand if someone might be a problem, ready to defend yourself. Even Halston Gracie used to teach that back in the day. The non-tall graphic, kick up the center line underneath the groin where you can't really pick it up. Yes, there's a difference between kicking it in a way where you raise your knee in tall graph and kicking it from underneath where you can't see. So if you want like more truer Systema, guys, look at my real instinctive Russian self-defense, learn hard hit, FSB Systema breaking structure takedowns. That will give you more of an idea of the totality of the system, if you will. And definitely go to George S. Pogacich YouTube pages. He will blow your mind. He will make you go, oh, some of the stuff he's doing isn't real. Yeah, it is. He has immense power and precision. There's a video back in the day. People think I'm acting where he slaps me in the stomach from a few inches away. Or smacks my arm, chops my arm from a few inches away. I am in horrible agonizing pain down on my knees. That's legit. And most people are haters because they suck in comparison. I don't know how else to say it. Most humans are pathetic. They are not looking for everyone to excel. And they'd rather everyone be worse than them as opposed to them raising themselves up and everyone up in any and all ways, including martial arts. So try to raise up. The way I articulate myself in speaking is probably better than writing. No, I don't think I'm the best. Never said I was the best MMA fighter, best fighter, anything like that. But I all right in all ranges of combat in all kinds of different ways. And, you know, always try to explain people, look outside the box, pick up what's useful. And I'm trying to show you some things. And yes, this is a beginner here, but I just did up arm fold takedown into an armbar. The training like this, even soft, boy, that can be helpful when you've bounced like I have, when you've fought multiple opponents like I have, faced against weapons like I have, for real. So I hope this will just enlighten your eyes a little bit. I think more people probably get more out of Systema, especially nowadays, Maybe in the 90s it was a little different, but especially nowadays, if you had a large background, physical background before you were 40, where you were doing combat sambo, where you were doing judo, where you were doing all the hard styles, I think you'll get more out of it. Even Vasilia was a very experienced karate guy. Unless you're a guy like Robko, who was trained since early childhood by one of Stalin's bodyguards. Or unless if you're in charge of the USSR's ballistic missile, interballistic missiles, entire program during the Cold War. Pretty important. You're a physicist, literally a rocket scientist, a pretty smart guy in Kato that could understand biomechanics and physics. So no matter what martial art, shouldn't you try to take that and become better? Apply it? I hope you guys will give it a thumbs up. And anyway, I'm just sharing what footage I have and what knowledge I have, and I hope you enjoy it. I may make another video that even better kind of compiles and shows things, but this is all the stuff that's more sparring, and that's what people have been asking for all these years. So I will catch you on the flip side. Thanks, everybody.